I am Sameen Ansari, and I am the creative director at DOBARA. I started doing this last year, and I have been having the time of my life working closely with my mom, and it's such a blessing. Let me tell you all a little bit about DOBARA. DOBARA is a network of members and volunteers from all over the world who are committed and focused on spreading a senior well-being and promoting healthy and active aging. It's about spreading goodwill, being positive, and being there for each other. And I think that's the biggest strength of DOBARA. And since last year, we've done really some fun things in spite of the situation in the world. We started a virtual well-being program, which is we put everything that we do in real life online, and it's been working out really well. We've done some really fun sessions. I see Sangha Mitranti in the audience. She recently hosted our first cooking workshop on Zoom, which was awesome. Just to let you know, we are constantly doing events and activities online on Zoom, and they're open for everyone. Everyone is welcome to join, the more the merrier. And the one thing that is very exciting that's coming up this Saturday is our annual Vana Bhojanam, which is a picnic in the park where we all meet and we eat under the trees and we enjoy the outdoors. And so that's our first in-person meeting since forever. I don't even want to, it's in 2 years. So if you're interested in joining our picnic in the park, there's lots of fun people coming. You can check out our website under events. You'll see the details. We also have the next
Your audio is off, Sameen. So shall I?
Hello.
So let me introduce Dr. Maria Samreen, the speaker today. Young Dr. Maria Samreen has been in practice in the dermatology field for 5 years now. She's a graduate from Shadan Medical College, and she's a consultant at Dureshavar, and she spends her time between two clinics of her private practice, one at Shantinagar and Vijayanagar and one at Masav Tank. And then she also consults. And she's the consultant at Dureshavar, she said. So now with Dr. Maria Samreen, we look forward to getting to know how, as we are growing up, whatever the skin changes, how we handle it well. And we look forward to you, Dr. Maria Samreen.
Yes. Good evening, everyone. Hello, everyone. I'm audible to everyone. Yeah?
Yes.
Hello, everyone. This is Dr. Maria Samreen. First of all, I'm very thankful to Matinapa and Sameen to have me here. And so good to be among such happy faces and spread the knowledge, little bit of knowledge I have. So glad to be a part of this meet. So today we are going to focus on skincare routine for all the age groups, focusing on the elderly. So the screen visible, everyone?
Yeah.
So today we will discuss one of the common reasons, common infections, common skin issues people face. And we'll be discussing a small part of treatment, small skincare routines, and what a dermatologist can help you with. So let's start our session. The most common, today we'll be discussing most common skin disorders, causes, and their treatment. One time or the other in our life, we all have experienced skin issues at a teenage or the old age, but you are not the only one. There are many of us affected by skin diseases, but not everybody is so much aware of the conditions. Let me enlighten you with a few of them. First of all, skin issues arise due to various factors. The most common is the genetic factors and the dry skin due to weather conditions. We also face issues due to overexposure to sun rays and also due to infections, your overdose of any drugs, or at the end, and the most common reason, the not taking the proper care of our skin that can lead to various skin issues. And let's discuss all of them in detail. The most common one, which we have, I can see we have young crowd too. So for them especially, the most common skin issue in the youngsters is the acne. It is actually nothing but a clogging of the skin pores of the face by a bacteria. So two-thirds of our nation, two-thirds of the world's population of teenage is affected by acne. So for you all the youngsters, this is for you. The treatment is basic, just clean the face, use antibacterial like clindamycin, benzoyl peroxide creams, and not to forget your sunscreens. And please do not scrub your face. The acne people, they have 4 to 5 types of acne. Popular, papilla, nodular, comedone, small pimples, big pimples, the red bumps, the various types. So the common mistake these people do is scrubbing and facials. So what precautions do we have to take with the acne prone face is not to scrub, not to go for facials. The more you scrub, the more you massage, the more chances of the comedones breaking out, the pimples breaking out. Okay. And what kind of treatment do they need? They need antibacterial treatment like clindamycin creams. They can use salicylic acid face washes. They can use. So this is a treatment for them. And milk products, butter, cheese, mayonnaise, all the dairy products, they have to avoid. And fruits like papaya, dates can aggravate the acne symptoms. So these are the things to avoid. And many of the time people ask, pimples, they come and go. Is it necessary to consult a doctor or is it necessary to take a proper treatment for acne? Trust me, guys, the acne will come, the pimples will come and go in a week or so. But the acne complications like dark spots and acne scars will remain, which will manifest in your 30s and 40s. So get your acne treated for all the new generation over here, the teenagers here, and anyone who's having the acne, please get it treated when it's in the first stage of pimples. Don't make it go to spots. And now we'll come to one of the common things, eczema. Eczema is nothing but it's the severe itchy dry skin. The most common types are atopic dermatitis, allergic and nummular dermatitis. This eczema we usually see in people around more than 45 years of age. What are the factors which cause eczema? What is eczema basically? Eczema is nothing but extreme form of dry skin. The most common age group is more than 45 years of age. Your elderly aging population has this issue of dry skin, the itchy legs, itchy hands. It is because of the genetics sometimes, your overexposure to the sun rays, and not taking proper care of the skin. As I said, this is the most common reason. In the elderly, what do we find is the oils, the moisturizing oils, which are given to us by the body in our skin, they start evaporating once you reach your 40s. So because of no oil in your skin, there's no moisturizing effect. Your skin becomes very dry. And because of the dryness, you feel the itchy feel. That's nothing but dry skin or eczema. So what we have to do is clean the skin and keep moisturizing it. Never let it go dry. That is the only solution. So this is seen in the elderly people, as I have already said. Please, the elderly who are having the itchiness in the legs and hands, kindly moisturize yourself. That is the only solution. Don't keep your area dry. Wash it, wipe it, and moisturize it. liquid paraffin, soft paraffin, any moisturizing agent you can use, that's the only solution. Because if you don't moisturize and let the skin dry, the itchiness, the marks, abrasions, you may suffer. So just every night, moisturizing your hands and face and legs is very essential, at least for the elderly. And in this we see in third world countries, usually this is the most common infection, skin infection, which I see in my OP around like out of 10, at least 8 cases come to me of fungal infection. That is so rampant and so common. Why is it so common? Because fungal infections are contagious, skin infections are contagious. One member in the family has it, it spreads to the entire family. It's due to not maintaining personal hygiene, unclean socks, and unhealthy eating habits. And if you have immunosuppression, like less of immunity due to diabetes or HIV, in such cases, fungal infections aggravate. So how do they manifest? Fungal infections, the symptoms are itchiness in your groin area, itchiness in your inframammary area, in your underarms, in the flexure parts, you have lots of itching. That is a common part, and ringworm in the normal language, common layman calls it a ringworm infection. So for that, please, how do we protect ourselves? So by keeping our body dry after taking shower and always washing your hands after handling your pets, because this fungus can spread from the pets too. So please wash your hands after you're touching your pets and change your socks every day. And the most common mistake, as I have told you regarding the acne too, the people don't take the treatment in the starting stages and they suffer with complications like scars and spots. And what people do, what's the mistake people do in fungal infection is they use steroid-based cream, Betnovate, Clobeta. So kindly don't use, misuse of steroids can lead to resistance of fungus. Kindly avoid steroid creams for fungal infections. And dandruff, I think every other person has a dandruff issue. So for dandruff, if you have itchy scalp or flakes falling on your date night, so kindly don't worry. It's a very small and simple thing. Dandruff is nothing but a minor kind of fungal infection. Don't go for this branded shampoos because they won't fetch you any result. They just market, these brands market themselves as anti-dandruff shampoos, like I don't want to name, but they won't fetch you results. Just go for ketoconazole shampoos. This is very easy, very simple. That's why I want to get into detail. Ketoconazole shampoo, which I have mentioned on my screen, every alternate day, take a shower with this shampoo for 2 weeks. In just 2 weeks, you will be like getting rid of your dandruff magically. Any brand will be okay, but ketoconazole, that's a chemical name. You should please note it. And yeah, almost everyone has this issue, hair loss, a very common problem in males and females, and let it be any age group. This hair loss is, what are the causes of hair loss? Hemoglobin, deficiency of hemoglobin will 100% give you hair loss. So if you are, anybody's having hair loss, please see your hemoglobin levels, your thyroid levels, your calcium levels, your vitamin D levels. This vitamins, this mineral deficiency will 100% give rise to hair loss. So whenever you're getting hair loss, just don't go for shopping. Just actually get your lab investigation done. Hemoglobin, calcium, vitamin D and thyroid. Once you're done with that, then you have to think whether are you using soft water or hard water for your shower. If you use hard water for shampooing your hair will for sure fall. Please use mineral water or soft water for washing hair. Second issue, if you have dandruff, then the dandruff, as I have earlier said you, that's a fungal infection. Dandruff will weaken your root hair's root. That will make the hair fall. So the third point is you check yourself whether you have dandruff or not. So your water, your dandruff, and your lab investigations, if you are done, just step by step, you yourself can diagnose what is the cause behind your hair loss. Once you have diagnosed your hair loss, what preventive measures can you take? Then there comes, you have diagnosed yourself, you have, then once you have the diagnosis in your hand, you can visit your dermatologist or hair specialist, trichologist in your area. what food do we have to take for proper hair growth? Omega acids do wonder, give you wonderful results. Vitamin A, vitamin C, iron. I have told you, iron deficiency can lead to hair loss. So you start taking your iron tablets, vitamin A, vitamin C. You know, vitamin C, if you take, you will have a good hair growth. Along with that, vitamin C also gives a skin glow. It has antioxidants. So vitamin C has dual benefit for your hair and also for your skin. Vitamin A, again, which you see in amla and carrots, vitamin A has effect on good effect on your hair, and it also helps in anti-aging process. So for anti-aging, vitamin A, retinols are amazing. They give you amazing results. And not to forget the biotin. Biotin is like compulsory for your hair growth. If you see hair growth, just start taking biotin tablets once a day for a month or so. And if nothing is working out for you, no shampoo, no tablets, and you're not able to diagnose yourself, then kindly get a PRP hair loss treatment done. This is a very good thing, which modern thing, which we are doing. A lot of dermatologists are doing this. PRP hair loss. In this process, we just take growth factors from our body, from the blood of the patient, and inject it directly in the scalp. It has amazing result, but the condition is the hair fall should be between 30% to 40%. So don't wait for getting the entire thing gone and half bald. Now let's come to our favorite topic. The most awaited topic is aging. Why do we age? Scientists were very curious, why do we age? Why can't we be young and dynamic and have a plumpy hair, hydrated skin always? So now General Herman in 1956, he proposed a theory of aging. Due to aging, as we age, due to weather changes, due to sun exposure, free radicals are produced in our cells. These radicals, they go and damage the DNA of our cells. Because of the DNA, as we all know, we must be knowing, the entire body is nothing but a unit of cell. And our cell works on the DNA. Because of solar damage, because of photo, sun rays exposure, weather changes, stress, diabetes, hypertension-like disorders, photo exposures, stress, psychological disturbances, all this lead to free radical development generation in our body. They go and directly attack on the DNA of the cell. Now the cell can't function. It has decreased abilities and decreased function, and they may die too. That causes the aging process. Let's go into detail. There are two types of aging, intrinsic aging and extrinsic aging. Intrinsic aging means the factors from our body which are causing the aging phenomena. Genetics, and especially in women, as the menopause comes, there's a decreased estrogen hormone. The beauty, the entire feminine features a female has, it's due to the hormone estrogen. And as with they reach the menopause, there's decreased production of estrogens. And because of that, women lose calcium. That's why they have joint pain. They lose the collagen of skin. Because of that, there's no tightness, there's no grip in the skin, and the skin starts sagging. Our skin is kept in hold, it is in position and tight, as in young people, because of the collagen bundles. Because of no estrogen, bundles will be damaged, and there will be sagging skin and wrinkling in women especially. Now let's come to extrinsic aging. Extrinsic aging is nothing but the factors, so external factors will damage our skin. Like photo damage. Photo damage means UVA, UV rays, and solar exposure damage, smoking, stress, poor nutrition, pollution, excess of alcohol intake will lead to reduced immunity. And reduced immunity will aggravate, you know, ramp up, fasten up your aging process. These are the external factors which can cause aging. So now what exactly happens after, once you hit your 30? There's decreased production. You know, cells of the skin, they are recycled every 28 days. Every 28 days, the new skin forming, the new baby skin coming naturally to everyone, female and female. So every 28 days, there's a cycle. Okay. But as you reach your 30, the cellular turnover, the cell cycle, you know, it starts decreasing. And because of that, you have the wrinkles and fine lines coming once you age 30. And the collagen bundles, I have told you, always remember this, your skin is tight and in hold position, there's no wrinkling, only because collagen bundles are doing the job efficiently in holding your skin tightly. As you age, the collagen bundles decrease, so they can't hold your skin that tight, and the skin starts sagging. Decreased fat, decreased blood vessels, and is a process of aging. And sweat glands, I have told you, sebaceous gland. Your skin, the young skin is very oily and very moisturized when compared to the old skin. Because of the glands, we have like sebaceous glands and sweat glands. With the aging, the glands also decrease. And of course, there's no moisturizing effect, and we face dry skin issues as we age. What are the signs of aging? Dryness, wrinkles, freckles, moles, skin tags, spider veins. What are spider veins? The blue veins, which we can see in few people. These are all the signs of aging. And the most common, you know, now we have discussed the aging factors. We have discussed so many things, but we cannot stop our genetics. We cannot change many factors. But what we can keep things in control is photoaging. What is photoaging? It is the aging process caused due to the sun exposure. This is one thing which is in our control. Sunburn and sun tanning can be avoided. How to avoid sun exposure? By using sunscreen. 40 to 50 SPF sunscreen is really good. And please have good fruits, vegetables, oral hydration, no smoking and all. What is a good skin care? What do you exactly have to do? You have to exfoliate. At the end of the day, please use a face wash or something which exfoliates your dead skin layer, which has been caused due to the entire day of stress and pollution. Use an exfoliant physical face wash containing salicylic acid 1% or something like that. It will truly exfoliate the entire makeup, the foundation you're having, the pollution you're having on your face. Everything will be removed at the entire day. Okay, then hydrate your skin with moisturizers. And if you are above 40 or something, like 30, 35, please start using retinoid creams, vitamin A retinoid creams. They are anti-aging creams. So at the end of the day, you have to wash your face with salicylic 1% face washes and apply a layer of moisturizer and vitamin A retinoid serums on your face. And in the morning, what do we have to do? We have to protect our skin from the sun rays by using a sunscreen. Sunscreen, always remember, guys, it's like a toothpaste for your teeth. You have to brush your teeth daily. No matter you are tired, no matter you are busy, no matter you have a party or not, you brush your teeth daily. The same way you have to apply sunscreen daily, no matter what. If you're in the house, still you have to apply sunscreen. If you're going out for work or a jog, still you have to apply sunscreen. The way you have been built in your mind that you have to brush your teeth daily, the same way for your skincare, you need sunscreen daily, come what may. And the earlier you start, the better for you.
So Dr. Samreen,
yes,
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
The sunscreen, does it go before the moisturizer?
Sunscreen is for morning purpose.
But do you put it on your screen before you moisturize or
yes,
after?
First layer of the skin should be sunscreen, but these days we have sunscreens which are also having moisturizers along with that combination creams we are getting. Because sunscreen is to be put early in the morning, and we are all in a rush of offices or colleges or whatever we are in that. So we have to follow a skincare routine which is practical for us for the rest of our lives, for a long duration. So I would suggest, ma'am, please go for a sunscreen which is also having a moisturizer in it, and also BB effect creams also coming. So that will, for females especially, that BB effect will give you a foundation like glow. So one sunscreen is fulfilling your glow thing, your moisturizer, and also sunscreen. So please go for the combinations one. And a 40 to 50 SPF of sunscreen would be fine. Hello? Yeah.
Got it.
I got it. Yeah, now, so let's get back to our topic. So the maintenance of the skin, I have told you, and that was a nice question. She must have cleared many doubts of the participants here. Morning sunscreen is essential. And at the end of the day, when you get back to your house, salicylic face washes, moisturizer, and if you want the glow, if you're in your 20s and 30s, vitamin C serum. Please mix your moisturizer with vitamin C and vitamin E serum and apply on your face and sleep. You can see the amazing result the next morning when you get up. You'll find a plumpy, hydrated skin. It's a personal experience, trust me. And if you are in your 40s and 50s, at the end of the day, please wash your face, exfoliate, mix your moisturizer with vitamin A retinoid serums for anti-aging phenomena. So this is a basic routine. Your skin will thank you later. So now once the, this is for the moisturizer and sunscreen, now for the maintenance. Now what for rejuvenation? Already we have, many of us have damaged skin. So for them, what do we have to do? The rejuvenation procedures, once you reach your dermatologist or your skin specialist, they will be guiding you for, with the maintenance, which I have told you. But what to be done for already damaged skin, for already wrinkled face, what do we have to do? And then for that question, we have options like chemical peels, Botox, fillers, laser treatments are few of them. We have an entire basket of procedures in our derma range, but I'll be discussing the most common ones here. What's a chemical peel? It's nothing but, you know, it's a chemical solution which is applied on your face for a few minutes, depending on the peel you use. After a few minutes, there's a peeling of an entire dead layer of the skin comes out. So what you have is a fresh, new second underlayer of the skin, which will be glowing. What are the benefits of chemical peeling? It will stimulate the collagen, which was damaged to sun exposure. So because of stimulation of collagen, there will be reduction in the wrinkles appearance, decreased pigmentation, and improves the open pores. Many of us may have open pores issue. So chemical peels, you know, they shut down the small pores and will give you an even toning. Botox, it's nothing but botulinum toxin A injection. It was actually produced for nerve blocks, but luckily we dermatologists, you know, started using for some cosmetic purposes also. If you have wrinkles like the frown lines, the glabella lines, the crow's line over here, and nasolabial lines, already wrinkled, so many wrinkles in the face, you can get a shot of Botox done. You can see the before and after pictures of this person. Yeah. And but Botox effect will be there on your face for like 6 to 9 months only. You have to get it done again and again. The fillers are the latest trend we have is the hyaluronic acid, human and Sculptra fillers. It is done for the frown lines, crow's feet, as you can see on the screen, the smile line, anything you are having wrinkles, you can just get the filler done. It's very easy, it is painless, and it is very side effect less. It's totally safe. And the trending thing for the entire Bollywood, Hollywood, the models can't survive without these, trust me. So these are the filler lines. And to be clear here, the filler's effect will last only for 1.5 to 2 years. You have to get yourself done again. We can see the difference between before and after lip augmentation fillers. Carbon facial laser, this is a very good laser for covering your fine wrinkles, for your acne prone skin and oily skin. This is also latest development in our thing, which is pretty much done. So at the end of the day, what's the role? First of all, please educate yourself for proper skincare. Your skin will thank you later, and it's better you start as early you start, it's the better for you. And get yourself checked, sunscreen in the morning, moisturizers and serums in the night time. That is a basic thing. And your hemoglobin and thyroid, everything has to be in control. As soon as your hemoglobin level falls, you will start feeling pigmentation on your cheeks, especially ladies of 40s. Pigmentation on the cheeks is melasma. So please get your basic lab investigations done. Use your sunscreen and serums in the nighttime and you're good to go. And for any cosmetic good appearance, you know, to feel confident or your job demands, we are always there. And last but not the least, what fruits to eat for glowing skin? Oranges has vitamin C, lemon has vitamin C. Mango will give you lots of weight, but it has vitamin A. So if you're thin and fine, you can go with mangoes. Strawberries, cucumbers, watermelons, and apples. Apples, you could show some vitamin A too. So these are good for your diet following and also for your skin glow, except the mango. So this is, Thank you. Any further doubts, I would love to entertain and I would love to answer your queries.
Dr. Maria, if we stop the screen share, then maybe we'll get to see everyone.
Yeah, sure.
Through the gallery view. All right. No, that was really interesting because what you talked, so I do use sunscreen every day since about the last 6 years, I think, because I started noticing that my skin is sensitive to sun. And you're right. And I keep telling my mom, by the way, Dr. Maria, to use also sunscreen. But then she's like, but we're not going out for 1 year. You know, it's been the lockdown. And like you said, whether you're at home or you're going out, you should wear sunscreen.
Yes, yes, that's the most important. Even this is the question all my patients ask. We are in the house, what's the use of sunscreen? But you have to use wherever you are, however you are, how much busy you are, sunscreen must.
Yeah. And then you talked about chemical peels, and I've heard that term, and it just sounds really painful. Like the idea of peeling a layer of skin off just makes me shudder with fear.
This is the same reaction my patients give when I offer them chemical peel procedure. But the name is scary, trust me, but it is nothing like peeling off. No, there's no mask kind of thing peeling off, just a few dead layers, skin cells peel off, which you can't even see. And it's totally painless and side effectless. There's no downtime. You can get it done, go for a party, go for an occasion or a meeting. So no downtime, instant results it will give.
And so it's not painful to your skin.
No, no, no. The name looks scary. The chemical, the peeling, the drama around the name, but nothing as such. It's the most common thing, most basic thing people get it done.
Does anyone else have any questions? Please feel free to. Oh, wait. Sorry. Let me allow everyone to unmute. Please feel free to unmute and.
Yes, I have a question. Mamta here.
Hi, Mamta. Happy birthday.
Thank you so much. Okay, doctor, actually, I have tried this sunscreen, but always when I put sunscreen apply, I start getting pimples.
Okay.
So I leave it then.
No. The sunscreen you must be using must be comedogenic. Pimples means comedones. In dermatology language, we call pimples as comedones. Please look for the details of your sunscreen. The sunscreen has to be non-comedogenic. If at all you're using comedogenic sunscreen, you surely will have pimples. And there are brands which have greasy kind of texture, which will make you lose interest and stop using sunscreen after a week or so. So I would recommend, please go for matte finish sunscreen. They are amazing, very lightweighted. They give you good foundation kind of effect, which I personally use. So don't go for greasy, oily sunscreen. Go for matte finish and please check the composition and go for non-comedogenic. The sunscreen has to be non-comedogenic. Please change the brand. The problem is in the company brand.
Okay. Thank you, doctor. But can you suggest a couple of brands? Which ones are
good? Where do you see, madam? Where do you see, ma'am?
India, okay. Hyderabad.
You can go for Lashield, amazing.
Okay.
Lashield and Sunband Soft. Sunband Soft and Lashield is amazing. LASHILD, okay. Yes.
Yeah, using this Lotus and all these, no?
No. This Lotus, Lakme, all these are the brands which I have mentioned. This brand, they just promote the name. And there's nothing in it. They won't even have the proper SPF and proper composition. They just loot you in the name of marketing, but they won't fetch you anything. They are very greasy, which will make, as I have told you, please do things which are practical for daily, day-to-day life. If you use for this greasy ones, you can't go to your meetings. It looks very tiring, tired face you'll be having. So please go for Lashield and Sunband. These are the two sunscreen which I personally use.
Ma'am, can you please type the spellings? Samreen, can we have the spelling of the thing in the chat?
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. I'm writing it down.
Okay. Thanks. Thank you, Doctor.
Yeah. Dr. Okay. Maria, can you tell me the name?
L-A.
Yeah.
S-H-I. E-L-D. Shield. La Shield.
Okay. It is Shield. Yeah, now I understand.
Yeah. And the next one is Sunband, S-U-N, Sunband, Sunband.
Mamta, I'm going to go, like I go to my pharmacy and get my sunscreen. So I'm going to go pick up some for mom. I'll pick up one for you too.
Oh, yeah. So sweet.
I'm coming soon. I'm coming in. Like, yeah.
Okay, these are available at pharmacy and not at a place where you get all that cream moisturizer. It's a beauty shop, right? No. Pharmaceutical.
I get mine at the pharmacy here in the Netherlands because I found that the pharmacy brand creams, also for mum, that the ones I get just seem to be a lot more softer and more moisturizing for mama. So yes. That's where I do my shopping at the pharmacy.
So now we are understanding. Skin ka raaz pata chal raha, Samreen.
It's the pharmacist. So
doctor is very right. Yeah, doctor is very right. Thank you so much, doctor. Thank you.
Thank you.
Are you back, Dr. Maria? You disappeared for a second.
Yeah, that was for like a mini second. Okay. I'm back, thankfully.
Good, good. Noor, you raised your hand. Please feel free to unmute and ask away.
Good evening, everyone.
Yes, Noor, would love to answer your query, Noor.
So recently, like I think last Monday, I have started using the over-the-counter, retinol. It's 0.025.
Okay.
So I've been experiencing a burning sensation, like inflammation. So is it like fine when we are using it? I'm also using, a thick moisturizer on that. So I hope that is fine if I'm doing that. Am I audible?
Yeah, Noor, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Okay.
So I have started using the retinoid. It's retinoa. Yeah, it's retinoa. Okay. Is what I have started using.
Okay.
So I'm using it in my nighttime routine. Basically, I never had one. I had the daytime routine where we use sunscreen, moisturizer, and then go ahead to work. But very lately I have started. So like, will I be experiencing any of purging in the coming days, or is it just normal that I'm not experiencing any of it, like as it's a 2-week duration right now?
Okay. So how long have you been using the retinol?
It's been 2 weeks.
Okay. So what was the indication? Why were you using it? Why do you want to use it? What's your skin issue?
Like I know a doctor, like she had, preferred, she is also aesthetic, the dermatologist. So she had recommended this, that, if you just start, because I've been facing these lines on my forehead, which I never had. Like, I think maybe it's because of the aging process that starts after you cross your 25. So I started using it for that, just to help my skin regain its quality. If I could say, I think that's the right thing. Okay.
So retinoa is nothing but retinoids, and this is winter season, chronic.
Okay.
So retinoa use can give, it's not recommended in winter season at all. The side effect of retinoa is active dryness. People usually, 100% people face dryness, and this is winter season. Please refrain from the use of retinoa in winter seasons. You will be having extreme dryness.
Okay, so I've been using it like on a daily basis. Should I avoid using it daily instead of should I use it like once in a week or something like that, just in not to stop it entirely? Or should I avoid it completely?
Yeah, please avoid it completely, at least for the winter season.
Okay.
It will cause a peeling of your skin and that will be a painful thing.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Oh, glad to help you out, dear.
Surely.
All right. I think we've talked and we understand now the importance of a morning and the importance of a night routine. I also tell mom when I'm with her, I try to deep moisturize her hands and feet at night so that when she wakes up, it's nice and soft. I hope everyone got something interesting out of this session, and I hope we are all going to start our routines if we don't already have them, change them around if we've learned something new today, and I don't know, here's to happy, healthy skin.
I'm sure now, from now on, nobody can forget the sunscreens.
Yeah.
I think I scared everyone. Sorry for that.
No, I'm glad, because I keep telling everyone too.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dr. Samreen.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Samreen.
Thanks.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Samreen. Bye-bye, everyone. Good night.
Bye.
Good night.
Bye, birthday girl, Mamta. Thank you.
Birthday girl.
Bye. Bye-bye. Thank you, everyone.
All the best.